Okay, thanks for the introduction. As announced, my name is Stefan Kehler. I'm from the Parallel and Distributed Computing Group at Wageningen University. And today I'm going to talk about migrating parallel applications to the cloud. Or more specifically, I'm going to show you how to assess parallel applications with respect to the cloud readiness based on parallel design decisions. So if you look at the agenda, I'm going to introduce you to the topic that we're talking about. After that, I'm going to name the problem statement and address it inside the paper. And then I'm going to present our, let's call it the central contribution that we made in the paper. It's a new meta model. And I'm going to explain how to do the cloud readiness assessment based on this meta model. And after that, there's a short teaser for the extensive case study that is presented in the paper. So I won't be able to give you all the details because of the time limitations, but if you're interested in that, we can discuss that during the poster session. So to introduce you, we're in the field of high-performance computing, and high-performance computing means that we're talking about applications from and for the domains such as artificial intelligence, engineering and scientific simulations, or financial risk analysis, and so on and so forth. And designing these applications is a hard task. And if we want to design such an application, it requires us to have a deep understanding of parallel processing techniques and concurrency and all that stuff. And another interesting fact is that HPC adopts the cloud. So during the last years, a lot of cloud providers, so the major cloud providers such as AWS and Microsoft, they introduced new cloud offerings that are optimized for HPC workloads. So with new hardware technologies and accelerators and faster networks, all that is typically related to HPC infrastructure. And HPC itself writes in a white paper a few years ago that AWS now provides capabilities for entirely new application classes, so application classes within the HPC domains, and that because the capabilities and the performance of AWS and its offerings evolve, also the applications that can be run on AWS also evolve. That's interesting, but there are still a lot of problems that need to be addressed to finally run this application in the cloud. And the question is, how do we migrate these applications to cloud environments? Okay. As I said, the cloud providers, they evolved and they introduced new offerings and so on, but we all know that simply copying an existing parallel application to the cloud does not enable it to make use of cloud-specific properties, such as elasticity, so we cannot elastically scale our application, we cannot make use of the pay-per-use property. And if we look at both disciplines or compare these disciplines to each other, HPC is focused on applications, and this is a specific type of application, so we talk about applications that are designed to solve very large problems, and this is why we focus on parallel performance in terms of speed up and parallel efficiency. And we do that because the scalability is inherently limited, so this is why we have to care about parallel efficiency to make use of these applications at all. In cloud computing, it is rather focused on the environment, and that's the cloud. So we are focusing on cloud-specific properties, and existing research basically looks at web-based multi-tier applications and tries to ensure cloud-specific properties that we all know, such as elasticity and pay-per-use for these kind of applications. And these applications tend to be perfectly scalable, so we don't have that much dependencies in high-performance computing, so efficiency is not an issue. So what we can see here is that HPC and cloud computing disciplines, they follow fundamentally different goals. On the one side, in HPC, we always try to improve the performance in terms of parallel efficiency, and in cloud computing, we have to take care of the cloud-specific properties to make use of them. This also leads us to the problem statement. And because we're following different goals, we also have different design guidelines that have established over the years. In high performance computing, the parallel computing guides the design of an application, and suggest several design decisions that we have to make to ensure a good performance in terms of thermal efficiency. In cloud computing, there are other design guidelines that show us how to build a cloud-native application. For example, also the cloud computing patterns book is based on the ideal properties, and it says, basically says, if we fulfill these properties, our application is cloud native, which means it has the maximum cloud readiness that we can get. So if we compare both sides, on this side we make design decisions that lead to specific properties that ensure a good parallel efficiency. On the other side, these properties are prescriptive, so if our application has these properties, it has the maximum cloud readiness. But the problem that we address in the paper is, what happens if we want to do both? So we want to have the maximum parallel efficiency and we want to have the maximum cloud readiness for our application. And if we cannot ensure both, how can we identify the conflicts and deal with these conflicts, for example, to make design trade-offs? And while thinking about these questions, we understood that it's very important to understand how parallel design decisions affect an application's cloud readiness, and probably it's on the design level the most relevant requirement to successfully migrate an application to the cloud. And this is why we came up with an approach that enables assessment of an existing parallel application that is typically run in an HPC cluster environment to the cloud. So, at the next slide, I'm going to show a new meta model that we have designed to formalize all these aspects that I told you about the last 5 minutes. And what we can see here is the complete meta model. On the left side, we see that the cloud-native application design approaches prescribe a set of application properties. You can see them here. And on the right side, we formalize parallel application design. And parallel application design approaches, they include a set of design decisions that we have to make, and each of these design decisions leads to a specific parallel application properties. What's new here is that we introduce the notion of a parallel application profile that can be used to describe a concrete application in form of a set of these properties. And a second important element is the property mapping element, which relates a cloud application property and a parallel application property. And what we can do here is to directly relate these properties from different disciplines and describe their conceptual fit. So we can assess if this application property has a positive or negative effect on the cloud readiness of our application. And another approach, because we use this meta model, is to establish a generic model that can be used to put in every parallel application profile and assess it with respect to its cloud readiness. Therefore, we also introduced a so-called cloud readiness assessment procedure in the paper. I will not show it here, but it provides you with a kind of result that you can use to see if your application has a good cloud readiness or not. And it also provides hints for your design level approach further optimize the cloud readiness of your application. Okay, I'm going to show you just a short teaser of the case study. For the case study, we investigated three parallel applications for replica exchange molecular dynamics. That's a common approach. It's a medical simulation approach, so to say, and it addresses the protein folding problem, which is recognized as a broad challenge and has to be solved, for example, in cancer research or research to Alzheimer's disease. And we looked at three different applications. Basically, two are based on the MPI framework, and one is based on a new framework called WorkQ that we've taken from the literature. And we assessed these applications with respect to their cloud readiness. This is part of the model. I have not shown the model here, so you will not fully understand the assessment, but what you easily can see is that a minus relates to a negative effect on cloud readiness, and a plus symbol symbolizes a good fit for the cloud readiness of the application. So what we have basically shown here is our three applications for the same use case, and this also shows that parallel application design is able to deliver a good or acceptable parallel performance, but with a better cloud readiness if we move to this framework, for example. Okay, to conclude our contributions, we presented a first systematic approach, so we didn't find anything like this to combine these two disciplines or design level approaches from these disciplines to assess the cloud readiness of parallel applications. We analyzed different these application properties and presented a structure to formalize this design level knowledge, and the results are captured in a reusable manner. So the model that's presented inside the paper can be basically used to assess any application that runs in your existing data set. And this basically enables the assessment on the design level, so it means you don't have to do a lot of effort to assess your application. It's pretty easy if you know the characteristics that you already have made, because you have designed this application, and you get a basis for your decision making, whether it's worth to migrate to the cloud or not. So if it's not a good fit and it's a lot of effort to change the architecture of your application, you probably won't do it, or you simply copy it to the cloud without making use of elasticity and pay per use. That's also a valid option. And future work is, of course, to assess, use the model that we have built to assess more and more application classes, just to check them with respect to their cloud readiness, to identify possible candidates for cloud migration. And what we have seen, that there are parallel applications with unpredictable resource requirements. And of course, that's a perfect fit for the cloud, because we don't know how much resources we need in 5 minutes or in 10 minutes or in 1 hour. So we can make use of elastic scaling and pay-per-use property in the cloud to use the compute resources more efficiently. Okay.
Thank you very much. Again, questions or remarks?
Mike, your insights have feedback on the design of such parallel applications that aim to be cloud capable later on? I mean, because you understand what are the positive and negative effects with your transformation, and if you think back, can you maybe modify the design principles for the parallel applications so that your business becomes easier?
Okay, so as a guidance for new applications,
yeah, right.
Yeah, you already can use it for that, because you assess an existing application, you get a result, your cloud readiness is bad. So you go back and check your options that you have in your design space. So you can, for example, simulate, if I had taken this decision, what happens on this? So that's already possible.
Yeah. If you compare real numbers running in a cloud environment with your suggestions?
We did not, but the application that we assessed that are real applications. So our paper refers to a paper that introduces the application. And I think, for example, for the WorkCube framework, they're scaled up to about 200 workers or something like that. So there are results for these applications, but we did not do that. So it's just given in the paper that we reference.
Okay, thank you. Before you leave, we have another point.
Yes.
Do you want to do?
No, do you?
Okay.
Do.
Most of you will know that we have sponsors for this event, and there are two sponsors, particularly it was Frank who organized the sponsors, not me. And these are the ICSOC organization, that makes a famous conference of ICSOC, and the company SurfTech. And we have a representative of all this here, that is Professor Bernd Klemmer, and he will now give somebody, and I'm curious who it is, the ICSOC Young Researcher Award